Yo, I am Michael Jr. It is funny how life works. Gang bang. That's supposed to be like that's where the logo and stuff would be. But if you just saw my hands moving, we didn't set all of that stuff up yet. So earlier today, I wanted some coffee. Well, I kind of wanted some coffee, but I really realized that coffee kind of wanted me. You understand what I'm talking about in a minute. So I decided, hey, I know my wife always has some non-coffee stuff, and she's really smart and brilliant. She got this degree in culinary arts, and she could probably make me something that tastes like coffee, but didn't really have all of the stuff that coffee kind of has. So we got together just a little while ago and decided to try to make some. Check it.
It's chicory herbal coffee.
Chicory herbal coffee.
It's loosely coffee.
Loosely coffee, as in it's going to loosen you up.
No, as in it only looks like coffee, it doesn't taste or smell like it. So you make it like you make a French press.
I don't make a French press.
Well, I do sometimes.
Oh, you're not supposed to open it when it's on.
What?
That's what it said. That's what the instructions said.
No, it doesn't.
It said do not open while, what does that say on there? Important.
It says plug it before plugging cord into the wall, be sure to fill with water. Because if you turn this on empty, it can ruin the heating element in there.
Oh, that's what that means. I just saw important in red.
You
and
just
figured
assumed,
out.
What is it?
Yeah, we're going to be reading. Look at all the text.
That's because it's some three different languages or something.
Water's ready. Time to go. Ka-ching. It didn't beep or nothing. Okay. Now she's filling up the water.
So I'm going to put two in for right now and then add a third one later.
So two and a later is how many you should add when you're making non-coffee coffee.
When you put the drink in here, you have to twist this handle so that you can hold all the heat and steam in there.
Oh, okay, I believe you. I'm never gonna make this again.
No, it's just power, okay? Just in case you have a guest. I'm not available. I may want some French press coffee.
If I have a guest over and you're not here, they broke in. I'm not letting nobody in here. Well, guess who it is? They broke in our house. That's what they did. We got the foolproof fish. I don't know if fishes could be fooled. You're not a fish. You're a mammal. And the fish is like, no, I'm not. What does that sound? Well, the timer is going off, which means it's time to resume what we've been doing.
And you slowly press this.
It's a slow press.
Press
this. Is that what it's called, a slow press?
French press.
French press. Can you make fries with it? Does a pimp have a French press too? When they, like when their hands are all silky and long. I got an uncle who used to.
Silk press.
Oh, my uncle had a French press. It was French braids. Mm-hmm. He pressed it.
I drink coffee black, but I cannot drink fake coffee black because it's not delicious like that. So
I don't drink coffee black. Sorry.
I'm going to add some soy.
We're going to add some soy.
To mine.
And this right here is a gift that I got that I don't use very much. It's a cup.
Ember.
Oh, it's an ember cup. Hey, if you want one, go to the link below that we're now going to attach. You can get one. It'll keep your coffee warm the whole day. And this is the cup I use because it used to be her cup technically, but she's mine, so it's my cup.
Because he lost his.
Oh, well, it's the details.
Looks like a really strong coffee. It looks pretty amazing, but don't expect the taste of coffee. That's not what we're doing here.
This is fake coffee.
It's fake coffee.
Coffee. Don't want all the caffeine. And I also use xylitol. I don't use any fake sugars or chemical sugars because that stuff is just wrong. I was with a doctor one time. He was like, dude, leave that stuff alone. I was like, cool. And this doctor is legit. Like that dude, he been working on feet for a while. So he know what you should put into your body. Now let's add some creamer for my people who like creamers. See what a creamer does to it color-wise. Oh. Ooh.
Ooh. I know that was a lot, but you need it.
I did half and half. And then she's doing organic soy. Oh boy. Need a little more xylitol. It keeps separating too, look at it.
That's because of the soy.
Oh.
You can't can't see it.
The soy don't even want to be in here. I don't want to be in here. Separate me from this stuff.
If you need to ease off coffee, this is the best fake coffee to buy. Yeah. I've tried them all. This one's the best.
All right. Let me taste. It's delicious. I'm about to go to Starbucks. So the reason I went on ahead and did this little test, if you will, the reason I do this on a regular basis is what I really should say, is I don't want anything controlling me. Like, I like coffee, but I don't want coffee liking me too much. I mean, I don't wake up in the morning and suddenly I gotta have coffee. And I know a lot of people say that in a funny way. I mean, I gotta have my cup of coffee. That's not a place I necessarily want to live, and I don't recommend you live there either. Because if you can control those small little things in life that seem to try to control you, you'll be better when the bigger things come along. So what is it in your life? What's that small thing? It seems like it's not doing that much harm right now, that you could just cut it off immediately or cut it off for a certain amount of time just to ensure that you are the one in control. I'm telling you, if you can figure that out, you'll be a much better steward in the big things as well. Here's what it really boils down to. You want to be able to say yes to those things that your body wants to say no to. For example, here's a great example. You might want to say, yes, I'm going to work out. And then you get to the gym or you get close to it or you reach for your gym shoes and your body's like, whoa. What are we doing? You want to get all sweaty and I don't think that's a good idea right now. There's some cheesecake in there we could finish off. Like, you want to say yes to that thing, but your body is saying no. You want to say, yes, I'm going to eat this food. Yes, I'm going to have this broccoli that's going to be amazing. Yes, I'm going to have these vitamins. Your body's like, nah, we not. If you can get strong here, it changes the game in a significant way. On the other hand, your body at sometimes is going to want to say yes when you need to say no. We're not going to get into all the details right now, but I think some of y'all know what I'm talking about. So you want to put yourself in a position where you can say no regardless of what's going on. I'm telling you, put you in a much better position in life, because it is amazingly funny how life works. Choon, choon, choon. It's supposed to be the whole logo and stuff, supposed to flash. We won't got it yet. So anyway, I appreciate you. I'm Michael Jr. Boom. We out.